Okay, guys, it's Dave here.
Yeah.
And I am at the intersection of Highway 12 and Highway 7, just east of Goodwood? Yeah, Goodwood, I think. Anyways, so here I am. It is August the 19th. It's 8:45 in the morning. Oh, and I've been on the road for almost 45 minutes now. Not almost, but over 45 minutes now. Anyways, so I am on my way to Markham for a job interview, which I don't know why, but that's what I'm doing. I used to work in Markham years and years and years ago. Looks like I might be working in Markham again. Anyways, got an interview in 1 hour and 15 minutes. Hopefully I will be there early. I hate to be late for anything, really. So, but yeah, it's gonna be an interesting day. I got my cameras with me. I just drove by the wind farm. Hopefully on the way back I can stop and shoot some video of the wind farm. And I don't think I'll be here very long. I mean, it's not like, well, I don't really know what they're gonna get me to do for the interview other than ask me. I had to fill in a 12-page application yesterday, which I was a little bit apprehensive about when I saw how many pages it was, but actually it was I printed it out. It was quite the application. Other than asking where you've worked and what you've done all your life, there were some pretty interesting questions. So anyways, yeah, so I'm gonna keep driving here and probably do another video when I get there, and we'll see how it goes. I'm not nervous, absolutely not nervous whatsoever. I'm quite excited, actually, but a lot of people, they get nervous when they gotta go for an interview. But you know what, I look at it this way, I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just applying for a job. If they don't want to hire me, that's fine. This posting was 16 days old, and I applied, and literally within an hour, they called me. So that's generally how it is. I haven't been working since February, and this is the first place I sent a resume to. So that's usually what happens when I look for a job. It's usually I get two or three offers at one time. So anyways, I don't know why I chose this place, but it's right up my alley. It's just basically it's a job for a senior circuit board repair technician. So, and I am senior. I'm definitely a senior, so anyways, I'm gonna keep driving here. That took me 5 minutes, so yeah, oh well. I got lots of time. Lots of time to get to the big old TO, or Markham. Markham's north of Toronto. It's a little bit more laid back than downtown Toronto, but it's still quite busy and quite populated. It's really, you know, sprouted since I used to work here. So anyways, Okay, so interview's over. It's like 12:30 in the afternoon now. It was a long interview, mainly because the guy that was supposed to interview me was busy. So I don't understand why they'd make an appointment for 10 o'clock if the guy who's going to interview me is not available. I don't understand that. But anyways, some guy named Dave interviewed me. Big smile on his face. Said, "Oh yeah, you're the ideal candidate. Blah 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 blah." But then this other guy came in when he finally showed up, and he must not have read my resume. Well, maybe he did, but anyways, they don't understand the meaning of, repairing stuff. Anyways, he said, we have a confidentiality clause and a non-competition clause or something like that. And he was worried about me repairing stuff, you know, on my own. Like, I told him I repair stuff all the time. I have people sending boards from the United States and Canada to me to be fixed in the wintertime and stuff. "Well, what do you fix?" And I said, "Well, I fix pellet stove boards." He goes, "Well, yeah, you wouldn't be able to do those because we do pellet stove boards too." And I'm like, "Oh, which ones do you do?" And he goes, I can't remember the name of the place, but they're in the United States. I'm thinking, what? Wow. That's one stale apple fritter. Holy crap. Anyways, the guy, that was the main concern he had, is that, I wouldn't be able to do anything in the way of repairs. Outside of the place. And I'm like, "Oh wow, that's..." Anyway, I didn't say anything to him, but they said they got a couple more people to interview, and they'll get back to me. So I suspect. And then this other guy was in there too, and he's like, "Yeah, have you ever been fingerprinted?" And I'm like, "Not that I know of. Why?" "Well, we'd have to, you'd have to have your controlled goods certificate." And I said, "Well, I did have my controlled goods certificate when I worked for Safran. And it's expired now." "But no, they didn't do fingerprints." He goes, "Well, when was that?" I said, "2011. "Oh, well, yeah, it's different now. So if we were to fingerprint you, if you'd ever done anything wrong, it would show up. Have you ever had any run-ins with the police?" And I'm like, "Well, my ex-wife or girlfriend of 15 years tried to kill me back in 2010, but she went to jail, and I don't believe I was fingerprinted." Anyway, weird place. You walk in there, and you're in like a little vestibule with a foyer with like a door here, a door here, and a door there, and camera. Anyways, eventually somebody came out and opened the door. Like kind of a strange place. Looked pretty small, and wow, did it. Didn't smell very good. I can still smell the place on me. Anyways, they took me in the boardroom, and wow, pretty dated stuff there, I'll tell you. They probably don't even have a good oscilloscope. My oscilloscopes, well, all three of my oscilloscopes are probably better than theirs. But anyways, I don't know if that's going to be a go or not. And even if they were to give me the offer or whatever, I'm not sure I would take it. Anyways, as I'm going there, I know I've driven this route many, many times. I'm in Port Perry right now, which is on Highway 7. And that's how I go. Man, this thing is staler than a rock. Anyways, go along Highway 7. The back route, basically. And I get to Coppin's Corners, turn left, and I'm going down that road down in towards Pickering. And eventually, it usually turns into Highway 7 somewhere along there. But they've changed it all so much, there was no landmarks that looked familiar. I ended up down at the 401, which means I went all the way down to, you know, where I don't, like, this place was on Denison Avenue, which is north of Steeles. You know, I ended up way down at the 401 in Pickering. Anyway, so I ended up going along the 401 and up the Don Valley Parkway. Got off at Woodbine. It's like 7 minutes before I'm supposed to be there. And no indication at all, but come up to Woodbine and Steeles off to 404. And they've got like a cable draped across the road, and two guys are holding these traffic signals and everything. No sign saying that you need to go right, but luckily I was in the secondhand right lane, so I just had to cut over one, and then I went along Steeles Avenue and up Victoria Park. And then the place actually was west of Woodbine, so I had to kind of backtrack again. But yeah, I used to know Toronto really well, and somehow I ended up getting myself kind of, not lost, but way off track. Anyways, it was fun. It was an experience. Gets me out for the day. So we'll see how that goes. But not getting my hopes up. Anyways, there's plenty of places in Toronto to work. I just thought this one was it looks good on the internet, but I don't think so. They don't have schematics for anything. They said that they don't get the same thing all the time. It's like random stuff. And I'm like, really? Like, man, as soon as I fix one board for a business, they start sending me 20, 30, 40 at a time. Like, and it's always the same thing that's gone on them. So, you know, it's kind of weird that they don't get the same thing. Anyways. Not really my cup of tea, but anyways, I'm gonna finish this rock hard. Wow, that is hard, man. Like, rock hard. I'm gonna finish this apple fritter, and I'm gonna get back on the road. I'm probably about, my cell phone says 48 minutes away, but can't be that long. Port Perry is about 30 minutes from Peterborough. So anyways, and there's construction going along on this road, so. Anyways, I'm gonna finish my fritter, get back on the road, get back to the old Peter Patch, and apply at a couple different other places, I think.
doesn't look like it's in focus. There we go. Autofocus. There we go. That should look a little better. So anyways, here we are. As I said, I'm going to stop and check out the wind farm. So there's a bunch on this side of the road, and then there's some on the other side of the road as well. So I'm just going to do a tight zoom here and see if I can't... I'm sure that's not Siemens equipment, because it looks like it's running pretty smoothly. Oh yeah, I can get it really close. Why is the focus off again? I must have it set on manual focus or something. There we go. Let me just back out here a bit. Okay, to get it out of manual focus, I had to reset the camera, so zoom in here and should stay in focus now. But yeah, there's a northerly wind today, and these things are moving pretty good. You know, it is kind of windy, but there's quite a few on this side of the road here. And if you sit here with no traffic going by, you can hear them. You can hear the blades in the wind. I don't know if it'll get quiet enough here yet, but let's just zoom in and see if that's crappy old Siemens. You would think it would say it on the outside somewhere, but... man, those things are massive. The bottom of that must be, I don't know, 20 feet in diameter. I don't know if you can hear that, but there's like a whoosh, whoosh. But yeah, pretty cool. I don't know how much hydro they're generating here, but there's a few on the other side of the road as well, but they're down behind a hill. Pretty cool. Anyways, there you have it. Look at the wind farm.
Anyways, so thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Please like, give me a like there if you wouldn't mind. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. It helps my channel. And anybody that's got any comments, you can leave it down below in the comments section. Thanks for watching.